Hi everyone and welcome back. In the previous video we have covered mostly string related questions. Now in the coming videos we will talk about array based questions. Okay, array based questions like find out the missing number from a given integer from 1 to n, find the duplicate numbers from a given integer array, find the max and min from an array, find all pairs of integers whose sum is equal to the given number. So first of all, find the missing number from this array. Okay, this is our first question and how we are going to solve it. So we have given these two inputs. Okay, one input is consider like 5 and 6. Okay, and sum, this is the array and the number is 5. I mean, so array index start from 0 to n minus 1. So it is actually, there are 6 numbers in this array, and we have to find out which is missing from this array, and these numbers are actually in the continuous range. So we already know in the mathematics from 1 to n, if you wanted to get some of these elements, then there is a simple logic, n into n plus 1 divided by 2, right? Same logic we will use to solve this problem to get the initial sum of all these 6 numbers. Okay, so what we will do is consider the n is 5. Okay, the function will be like this: const get missing, here we are passing array and the number. Number is actually talking about index, so there are actually 6 elements, but from array index start from 0 to n, so it is coming as 5. So what we will do is, first we will get the total. Okay, so say const total equal to, either you do it with n into n plus 1 divided by 2, or the index is starting from n minus 1, so we can actually do n plus 1, n plus 2 divided by 2. It's the same is, because n is representing n minus 1, so we have to add the index plus 1 to this formula. Okay, so this is what we got, the total, I mean the total sum of the numbers which should come, right? If you talk about the 6 numbers and you wanted to sum all these elements, right, then just put 6 multiply by 7 divided by 2. It should comes out as 21, and if you just sum these elements, then it should also come as a 21. You can just add it 15. Okay, yeah, it is also 21. So this is same, right? This logic will work. Now what we will do is, we'll just run a loop onto this. For let I is 0 and I is less than n, I plus plus, because we are starting the index from 0, and what we'll do is, we'll keep reducing that total, I mean we'll keep deducting, subtraction we will keep doing with array of I. And finally, whatever the total we will get, we will just return that. So it is simple, right? What we have done is, we found out, okay, the total of these 1 to n, which is 6, is 21. Okay, this is 21. And the missing element from this, if you see, we keep subtracting 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. So finally, the output we will get in the result will be 4. So 4 is the missing number, a plain and simple one. Find the duplicate numbers from the given integer array. You can also do the same, you can create a map. We might have done this. So we created a map for strings. You can also create a map for numbers. Map of the object, here we already have an array. So instead of string, we can do array.forEach. And this map will represent, okay, which particular digit, which particular number in an array, how many times it has been occurred, right? So this is how we can get it. And our question is, how to find duplicate numbers? If any digit or number having the value in this map is greater than 1, that means that is a duplicate. Okay, find the largest and smallest. I think it should be easy, min and max. So initially what we will do is, we are getting an array. We'll initialize min max with 0 index. let min equal to array of 0 and max also array of 0. Now we can just run a simple loop for let I 0, I is less than array dot length I plus plus, and here we can just check if max is greater than array of I, that means we have some element which is greater than this, so max is array of I. Same, we can add a condition if min is less than array of I, then we can just reset the min with array of I. And finally, once this loop is done, we can return an object with max and min. Okay, so this is how we can get the min and max. Now what we are going to do is we are going to talk about our final question for this video is find out all the pairs of integers array whose sum is equal to the given number. So it is same question. What we are going to do is here this is an array we have. In this question, this is our array, and what we are going to do is we have to and sum is given as let's say 6. We have to find out the pair of elements whose sum is coming out equal to this. Okay, 2, 4, let me put 4 also. So the resulting output is expected as a 2 and 4 and 5 and 1, right? Because the sum of those elements are coming equal to 6. So for this, let's can write function, I mean const get pairs count, or we can also return an object. This is your array and this is the sum you are looking for. Here you can say count equal to 0. Okay, and we will just run a loop. So here we just need to run a loop onto this array. Okay, first we will run two loops, outer and inner. So first loop will just iterate these elements. Second loop will run inside it. So how we can do this? Let's keep 1 as a constant and keep adding 1 with 2, 1 with 3, 1 with 4, 1 with 5, 1 with 6. And we'll compare if the sum is coming out as a 6 or not. Then we will start with a 2. We will sum 2 with 3, 4, 5, 6. Then 3 we will pick and we will start 3, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 5, 6, right? So we have to just run two different loops to get the count, right? How many elements are there whose sum is coming out equal to the given sum? Simple. So count is 0. We are just running a loop till I less than n. And we started running another loop with I plus 1 less than n. And here we are saying is whenever the sum of array of I and j is equal to sum which is given to us, increase the counter. Okay. You can also put the brackets. Okay, and count plus plus you have to do here. If this comes out as a true, can you return the count? If you want to also return the pair of values, okay, output, if I want something like this, okay, in this array I have these many pairs, 2, 4 and 1, 5. Okay, it is just returning a count. Okay, these many elements, these many counts are there where we are getting the count. So the count will be 2 for this. Okay, but if you wanted to return the pairs, in that case, if this condition is becoming true, let's say we have pairs here which is an empty array. Here with the increment of the counts we can also push pairs, and in the pairs what we are doing is array of I and array of j. Okay, so array of I comma array of j, this will again inside an array. Okay, This is array inside array. So you can return pairs we are returning. So with the count, you can return two things, count and set of pairs. This is how it is going to work, right? So either you can get the count. Count in this particular case will be 2 because we have only 2, 4 and 1, 5. Do we see anything else? 6, 4, 3, 3, no, 3, 2, 5. We just need to get the only 2 values, not 3 values. So 2 values, these are the only 2 possible things. Count will be 2 and pairs will be this. Okay, it can be changed in many different possible ways. Okay, find the 3 different possible numbers whose sums comes equal to the provided sum, right? In that case, you can just run 3 different loops, array of I, array of j, array of k. If the sum is coming out equal to the provided sum, then return that index, return that value and increase the count. Okay, thanks everyone. This is the first set of questions on an array.